Excellent!
We tech reviewers like to make out like building a PC is easy. And it is, for the most part. But sometimes instead of being easy, it is hard. That usually means that you've encountered one of the following PC building paradoxes, but hopefully this video will put some of your fears to rest. Screw struggles. If you've ever had to bust out the pliers to separate a screw from a motherboard standoff, then you've already learned this hard lesson about our Phillips-headed friends. You see, the fact is that the PC building gods in their infinite wisdom chose to use two separate standards from opposite ends of the globe when choosing which types of screws should commonly hold our computers together. There is UTS 6-32, which is based on the Unified Thread Standard, which is used in the US and Canada. And then there is M3, based on the metric system. I usually call UTS 6-32 the coarse thread screw. It's used for power supplies, 3.5-inch drives, PCIe expansion slots to hold on your case's side panels, and most of the time, for motherboard standoffs. M3 I like to call fine thread. It's usually used for smaller 2.5-inch drives, whether they're hard drives or SSDs, for securing optical drives, and sometimes for motherboard standoffs as well, which is why it's always a good idea to check what types of standoffs and screws your case is using before installing your motherboard. Is it a UEFI or a BIOS? The BIOS, or Basic Input-Output System, is what your PC churns through as it boots up, and it has long been a place of fear and uncertainty for new PC builders. Now, we must also deal with the fact that newer motherboards don't have a BIOS anymore. It's become the UEFI for new motherboards since about 2014, which stands for Unified Extensible Firmware Interface, which really just rolls off the tongue and is not confusing at all. At least when I tell people what BIOS stands for, it would kind of click a little bit, and they'd be like, oh yeah, that kind of makes sense. To be fair, the BIOS has been around since about 1975, and the new UEFI standard was needed to allow booting from larger hard drives, for low-level operating system tie-ins that allow UEFI-based computers with Windows 8 and Windows 10 and an SSD to boot in like 15 seconds or less. Just remember that for you, it still works functionally the same as a BIOS. You can still access the UEFI by tapping delete during startup, you can still revert to default settings using your motherboard's clear CMOS function if you happen to screw anything up, and we've even been getting away with calling it the UEFI BIOS, even though that's not technically correct. Busting static myths. I've given my fair share of warnings about electrostatic discharge, or zapping something, to use the scientific term, but the fact is that I have never in my life actually damaged a piece of computer hardware with a quick shock from ESD. That's not to say that you should ignore ESD completely, but using practical methods to neutralize your static buildup, like touching your power supply's housing every so often while it's plugged in and grounded, is almost always enough to prevent any issues. Also, make sure that you're working on a non-conductive surface, like wood, so no metal tabletops, and if you live somewhere that's very dry, you should take extra care, as less humidity means ESD will be more common. CPU socket lever pressure and you. CPU installation can be a nail-biting experience even if you built a system before. Build guides like mine are always careful to point out just how delicate you should be during the step, but for the newer Intel LGA sockets, the fact is that after you ever so daintily place the CPU in the socket with the notches and the triangle lined up, you'll often have to wrench down on that locking lever with some significant force. You might even hear some creaking and groaning from down there, but like an elderly couple making sweet, sweet love, the cringe-inducing sounds will quickly subside once the payload is deployed. I should mention that if you're using a newer Intel Skylake processor, you should be a little bit more careful with this since their PCBs are thinner. And also apologies to any of my regular viewers who can now never install a CPU again without making that elderly couple association. What about this SSD is 2.5 inches? Don't you hate it when your computer parts are deceptive? Take a look at this 2.5-inch SSD, for example. I think most of you would agree that this is a 2.5-inch drive, but you know what? Let's check. So that's odd. This is actually more like 2¾ inches wide. Maybe they're referring to something else. Alright, so I have discovered that no part of this drive actually measures 2.5 inches.
You son of a bitch! You lie to me!
Okay, to be honest, this fact probably hasn't caused problems for you guys directly unless you've blindly attempted to scratch build your own case, but there it is. Neither 2.5 inch drives, nor 3.5 inch drives, not even the 5¼ inch drives that we hear about from legends of PC buildings past, are actually the size that they say they are. The measurement comes from spinning mechanical hard disk drives whose internal spinning platters do measure up properly, 3.5 inches or 2.5 inches, whatever the case may be. The only defense that I can think of for their deception is, I don't know, maybe it's just really cold outside. And that is all five confusing PC building facts. I had fun making this video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button down below. I could totally do some more videos in this series, so let me know if you have any ideas in the comments section. Also, you can use my Amazon link, which is down in the description. Click on that before you shop for stuff at Amazon, and that helps me immensely. Feel free to visit my store at store.paulshardware.net, where you can support me by picking up shirts or mugs or pint glasses. And lastly, consider subscribing to my channel if you're not already for the latest tech videos. And as always, thank you for watching. Screw struggles. This is kind of a tongue twister.